Hello, and I'm so glad that you are joining us for another reflection and reading from our Advent selections in the Gospel of Luke. Today, I'm going to revisit a passage that you might have heard earlier this week, and it is a passage that we have come to call the Magnificat, which is just Mary's prayer and song of praise after she learned that she was going to give birth to Jesus, who was going to be the Savior of the world. So I'm going to read from Luke chapter 1. I'm going to start in verse 50 and go through verse 53. His mercy extends to those who fear him. From generation to generation, he has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. And this passage has always surprised me because it's definitely not the place that my mind has gone in the times that my wife found out that we had kids, babies on the way. I never said to her, honey, I'm so excited. Praise God. I'm so glad that he has brought the rulers off of their thrones and he's exalted those who are humble. But yet, here's this surprising prayer from Mary. And it really is a profound prayer, though, because Mary knows the heart of her God, Yahweh, the God of Israel. And this is a God who throughout Scripture has consistently chosen not only to work out his plan of rescue and redemption through people, but he has consistently chosen to work through the kinds of people that the world has rejected. People that the world saw as weak, as poor, as uneducated, as the outcasts of society. And time again, God has worked out his plan of rescue through those types of people. Even look at the way that God has chosen to work through Israel. It was a nation that had nothing to offer on the global scale, nothing to offer on the economic scale, no military strength, no power. Why does God do that? Why has God consistently chosen to work through the lowly and the weak? And I think we can answer that with this one word, pride. God has worked in this way so that there would be no mistake that it was God who was strong and not people. It was God who saved, God who healed, not because of human ability. And Mary's prayer celebrates this. It's not because she hates the rich or the powerful, but she knows that pride is the great enemy of God's plan. The Apostle Paul, he gets at the same thing when he says this in 1 Corinthians chapter 1. But God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. God chose the lowly things of this world and the despised things and the things that are not to nullify the things that are, so that no one may boast before him. As we approach Christmas, may our hearts be prepared for a Savior who doesn't save you because you have something to offer in exchange, but a Savior who comes to save you when you realize that you have nothing and that you can't save yourself. That makes us 100% reliant on his grace and his mercy. And that's exactly what Mary is praising in her song here. Would you pray with me? God, you are a good father, and you have sent your son Jesus to deliver us. And it's the Jesus who gave up everything, gave up his power and his authority and his position in heaven. And he took on flesh and he came to us and he died a sinner's death on a cross. And it is in his death and resurrection that we have true life. So God, may we see that our humility and our lack is not a sign of weakness, but it is just an opportunity for us to rely on you. And when we rely on you, that is where we truly find life. And I pray in the name of Jesus, our risen Savior. Amen.